Well, listen, welcome to the Film and Media Awards, the first annual Film and Media Awards. Tonight we gather to celebrate your achievements, but of course before we dive headfirst into those awards, we need to go over a few house rules, so forgive the obligatory things. So first, if you must leave your seat to go to the bar or toilet, do it with the stealth of a ninja and return quietly before anyone notices. We don't want any empty chairs disrupting the delicate balance of our award-worthy atmosphere, I hope. While we're on the subject of seats, please remain in your allocated seat throughout the evening. I know the temptation to switch seats to be near your pal is strong, but let's try and resist that urge. Our talented caterers have juggled gluten-free, dairy-free, nut-free, almond allergies, aubergine allergies, kiwi allergies. I could go on, but among others. So let's not ruin the evening by inadvertently causing someone to go into anaphylactic shock. I don't want to be known as that guy who killed someone, so thank you. So secondly, acceptance speeches. We all love them. Maybe we all dread them if you're sat there in the audience. So here's the deal. Keep it short and sweet. Think of a rom-com that runs for 90 minutes or less. We don't need the retelling of your life story necessarily or a shout-out to every cousin that you have that's twice removed. But if I may offer one piece of advice, it's to perhaps think about mentioning your parents who might be watching the live stream and maybe your significant other. Otherwise, it could be a bit difficult when you get home. So basically, those people in your life who have put up with your shenanigans for long enough. So actually, that reminds me, please refrain from using any explicit language or offensive language throughout the proceedings. Just a gentle reminder that the event is live streamed and we have got young people sat in the audience with us today. So we want to keep it clean, keep it classy and suitable for all ages. Now, we understand that passions may run high during an award ceremony. Disagreements might arise over the rightful winner of a category. But let's remember that violence is not the solution. So if it is, we have our dear security partners who are here on site who will thoroughly enjoy earning their crust by escorting you off the premises. So yeah, please be polite and friendly to each other. So let's begin by addressing, I suppose, the elephant in the room. And yeah, I'm talking about the C word, but not that C word, of course. I mean COVID. I want to take a moment to congratulate all of you who are here tonight. You've proven that creativity and perseverance can triumph over adversity, even when that adversity comes in the form of a global pandemic. You should be really proud of that achievement. When I think about the 3 years that we've had together and what you've been through and what the staff have been through, to get to where you are here and to be going to graduation in a few weeks, is incredibly impressive, so you know, pat yourselves on the backs. Your films and your projects remind us about the power of storytelling and the importance of capturing the human experience. Now, over the past 3 years, I've had the pleasure of watching a number of the films that you've made, and beyond the technical quality, what truly shines through is the storytelling. Each of the films has a unique voice, an expression of the filmmaker's vision and passion. Tonight on show, we have tales of love and loss, triumph and tragedy, and tales that have defied conventions and challenged societal norms. These films remind us that storytelling has the power to unite, to inspire, and to ignite conversations that I hope can change the world. But enough about you and the films you've made. Let's not forget the unsung heroes of the film and media department, your lecturers. These are the people who, for many of them, have dedicated their lives to shaping the minds of future filmmakers and storytellers. They've endured, and I think I can speak for myself at least, endless late-night emails asking for extensions and witnessed the absurdity of your film pitches that make as much sense, maybe, as Nicolas Cage's filmography. They've endured your excuses for why your assignment is late, and so they deserve our applause and gratitude for their dedication, their patience, and their kindness. I mean, it was a push, wasn't it? I had to try hard there. Yeah. But tonight we celebrate your accomplishments, but I do want to take a moment to remind you about the importance of failure. Some of you will win an award tonight. Some of you will go away empty-handed. Whether you're clutching a trophy or simply wondering why your name wasn't called, remember this. Failure is not a sign of weakness. It's a call to action to see what you're truly made of. So in closing, I want to congratulate each and every one of you for your hard work, your dedication, and your ability to put up with, let's face it, Microsoft Teams. You are the future of the film and media industry, and I can't wait to see what you do next. And so remember that success is failure, just with better lighting. So thank you and enjoy the evening. Our first award is for Best Animation and will be presented by senior lecturers Rob Vaughan and Leah Appleton.
So when we selected our three nominations for Best Animation, we focused on the artists who demonstrated the professional attitudes and the work ethics which act as our benchmark for excellence. So in no particular order, we had Natasha Hardesty. She made a traditional animation with limited color palette and over 7 minutes long, which is quite epic for us. Alongside working on her final major project, Natasha also collaborated on a project at the National Film and Television School. Elliot Wheeler made a CG animated music video, taking full advantage of stock models and environments, allowing him to focus on his animation and directing. Tia Weller created mixed media animation using data moshing and artifacting to create a unique audience experience. The winner is Natasha.
Hi. First off, thank you to Rob and Leah. You've both been really supportive and amazing over the last 3 years. And big thank you to my friends, the animation gang over there. And yeah, thank you to my dad, who's my biggest supporter as well. I don't know if he's watching the live stream, but yeah.
Okay, so up next we have the Industry Networking Award and Best Artwork presented by Yulia Gleed and Alex Scott. Okay, so we've had an incredible year with our students, I think, this year, without a shadow of a doubt. And I'm here to talk about the Best Artwork Award. So the nominations for this year's Best Artwork are Ben Yasuri, Prasur Trinyugrang, or Poor, as we know her, for some incredible, stunning 2D artwork. Sunny Kelly, who's been on quite a journey with us across this year, doing some absolutely awesome work as well. And Jacob Leskey, who again has done quite a transformative journey with a lot of his 2D artworks through the year. And the winner is Sunny Kelly. All right, very good. We felt Sunny went on a journey as an artist through his final year, exploring the genre of body horror with a surrealist twist. Taking his ideas from multiple iterations and always acting on feedback, Sunny developed his own artistic style and design philosophy. Well done, thank you.
Well, thank you. I'm kind of a bit sad because my mum and my sister were meant to be here, but they're stuck in traffic, which really sucks. But this is amazing, I didn't expect this at all. Yeah, I think I'd like to thank mum, sister, family, you know, the generals, but also you guys as lecturers, because you've really been like a massive help with this year, because I came into my third year by myself, you know, just for the 1 year for university, and it's been a really weird ride, but you guys have been such great help, so thank you so much.
Okay, another award that we have is our Industry Networking Award, of course really important because we always encourage our students to network with the industry. They get a lot of advice from Alex, myself, and Ken, but it's nothing like advice from the people who do it on a daily basis. And our nominations include Ian Dickinson, Daniel Kulenka, Richard Leach. All three students worked on different projects, from research to 3D and Unreal work, and succeeded in the area of networking very well. So I'm gonna read the little blurb about the winner, and then I guess the winner will know, or at least our students will know straight away. So in exploring gender diverse character customization options in games, Ian reached out and interviewed several artists and producers from the games industry, as well as several game journalists. The results of his networking, comments and ideas he received led directly to his final conclusions about life rafting LGBT plus people into the industry through external organizations. So Ian Dickinson, congratulations. Well done.
All the best things come unexpected.
I didn't have a speech prepared because I wasn't expecting this. So thank you to the lecturers for helping me, for supporting me in my paper. Ken as well, even though he's not here. Miss you, Ken. And thank you to Cole, my fiance, for really supporting me during this paper. I couldn't have done it without you. So thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, so next we have the Best Photography Award presented by Frankie Murdoch.
Thank you, and hello everybody. If you haven't seen the photography yet, please go downstairs and have a look at it. It's a really great collection of what our media production students have been doing on the photography pathway. Three nominees go to Angie Ho for her Malaysian Artisans, a beautiful look at all these different people across her culture making these beautiful things. We've got Tom Hardy and his project on shifting shores, an important look at the impact of climate change on our coasts. And Josh Merry, whose very brave and very deeply personal project, Do You Remember When? Which is very interesting. So much talent, so much bravery, so much kind of connection with the landscape and with culture, but I am pleased to announce the winner is Tom Hardy.
I was not expecting to win this at all, but I'd like to thank Roy, the course leader, all the lecturers, including Matthew, who is he does the photography pathway. I wouldn't have done it without him and all of his support, and my friends and family, so thank you.
So up next we have two awards, the first of which is the Best Marketing Project, followed by Best Audio Project, both presented by Dr. Roy Hanney.
I'm gonna read from this because I've got three awards to remember. So I did have some help with writing this as well. So the first project is the Marketing Award. And there were a couple of exceptional projects that stood out from the work the students did. Luke's project is a sustainable vintage clothing brand, which beautifully merges fashion and sustainability. With Nathan's project, he was marketing a sizzling drum and bass night in Southampton, which set the stage ablaze in its electrifying experience. So prepare to be inspired as we recognise both of these students, really, who are going to go and have some fantastic careers in the marketing industry. Luke, would you like to come and get the award? Thank you.
Hello there. I don't really know what to say because I've never been in this situation before, but this is interesting. So if you'd have asked me where I was 5 years ago today, it would not be here. It's just absolutely incredible to be here. Needless to say, I'd just like to thank all the people around me, all of my lecturers, my mum and my dad, because they've been there for all my journey and my support. It's just been absolutely fantastic. So thank you very much. I really appreciate it all.
So the next project that I'm going to announce is for the audio production project, which is, you could think of it as podcasting, but we have various kinds of different podcasting. And the two that I'm going to announce, or the two shortlisted, is one is Costin, who's wandering around with a camera here somewhere. Her story was a captivating love story set in the waning years of communist Romania that intricately weaves history and emotion together. Whereas Joshua's project dives deep into the world of football in Southampton, capturing the essence of passion and camaraderie. So the winner is, Costin, can you put the camera down and come to the stage, please?
Well, okay, so I'm freaking out. I did not expect to come on stage. I was just expecting to take pictures of you guys. I'd like to thank my lecturers for helping me with my skills. I'd like to thank Paul, my supervisor, for showing interest in the topic, in discussing multiple times throughout our tutorials about history of communism and what life was like in Romania during the 80s. And I'd like to thank my parents, which were my co-producers. Without them, this story wouldn't have been possible. So thank you.
Okay, now we have our first sponsored award of the evening, which is for Outstanding Freelancer, presented by Grace Burton.
I think this combination of heels and steps is in the risk assessment, so you're going to watch me take a tumble off the stage. It's so nice to see so many faces. I think on every table, someone who's come and tried freelancing with Salient Creators this year. It's not too late. If you graduate and you want help setting up your business or freelancing, you have advice for us from life. We're just here, so it's my little advert. So at any point in your career, if you decide you want to go freelance, come and speak to us. We'd love to help. It was so hard to pick between these three, so I want to say something nice about each of them. Josefina Petrosova, who is... I'm heartbroken about her leaving because I haven't got a go-to animator now. She has been so professional in every project she's done. She's just been like, there it is, done. So, oh, okay, great. Andrew Thorne, who, again, who am I going to go to when I need a video saving, Andrew? Because you're going to really miss the team's messages from me saying, Andrew, what are you doing tomorrow? And getting you on set on a sheet. So thanks, Andrew. And Patrice, you've been part of Salient Creators longer than I have. I think since day one, you have been on the posters, you've been everywhere, and you've just been such a reliable pair of hands. So thank you so much. And the winner is Josefina. Josefina would like to thank my mum. We'll get it to her, it's fine.
Okay, so we are whizzing through these, which is nice because I think it means that we get the food earlier, so that's always a good thing. So we have Outstanding Industry Engagement, and this is sponsored by Solent Productions, and so this will be presented by George Baldwin. I've actually got a very long speech. It's not that long, actually. It's only about half a page. It's big letters, because I can't see very well. It's my pleasure to be here today presenting the award for Outstanding Industry Engagement. This award is intended for people that have given up the time throughout the year to work with Sonnen Productions and other university ventures to plan, develop, and deliver projects for industry clients. This year, we have had the pleasure of working with a number of prestigious contracts, such as EMG, delivering coverage of Southampton Football Club games, Hampshire Cricket, covering Test matches, T20s, one-day games, and Premier League games, Fresh Montgomery, covering the International Food and Drink Festival at Excel London, and a host of other in-house events for the university, not to mention our upcoming work with festivals such as NAS, Boardmasters, Come Festival North and South, and of course, Glastonbury Festival. Sorry. As a former Solent student, I'm really proud to see the Solent brand is still going strong and garner some prestige in industry. Some of our alumni are doing fantastic work as independent filmmakers or working for big broadcast companies like BBC, ITV, Sky, or subsidiary companies providing services for these, as well as a wealth of freelance talent that has come out of Solent. It's become somewhat of a running joke, but we seem to find an ex-Solent media, film, TV, or wider creative industry student on pretty much every job that we go on. And they all look very fondly at the time at Solent, including myself, as well as the work experience opportunities given to them by Solent Productions, Solent Creatives, and within their course. The talent and passion that our students have is immeasurable. Over the year, we have worked with dozens of students that have shown great interest and commitment to engaging with work experience opportunities within industry and developing their skills learned throughout their course and applying them to the real world. Their resilience, self-drive, and determination by some of the students we have worked with this year has not only been a credit to themselves, but also to their lecturers, support staff, and friends and family that also wanted to see them develop and succeed. I wish I could give this award to everyone that has worked with us. I see a lot of friendly faces around the room, but I only had a few people that I could choose, together with Craig. It has been an immense pleasure to see some of you grow in confidence over the year and apply yourselves fully. And I can confidently say that if you follow this trajectory, you should have a great future in the film, TV, and video production industries. However, Craig and I could only nominate 4 people for this award, and the nominees for this year of Outstanding Industry Engagement Award are Tom Russell, also known as Russell, Luke Small, Darcy Richardson, Tomas Delega, and the winner for the Industry Engagement Award is Tom Russell.
Wow, thank you very much. I should probably start by saying well done to all the nominees as well up there.
Oh, there you go.
Thanks, thank you. But yeah, they're all incredible people, so yeah, well done. And thank you, George and Craig and everyone else that helps. And yeah, I didn't expect that, so thank you very much. Cheers.
Okay, so now we are on to Best Dissertation, and this will be delivered by Dr. Mark Aldridge.
It's not my title, but still. I love dissertations. I mark them every year. I get to speak to students every year about their dissertations. They aren't sort of as glamorous as some of the things that we're going to be celebrating tonight, but the thing I love about them is that we get a really deep dive into what particular students are really interested in particularly film and television. So it's very difficult to compare them to each other, and it's almost a shame that we have to mark them. It doesn't stop us, but it is a shame that we have to give a grade to something that people have worked really hard on. Our nominees this year are Ella Perkis for Ethics and Untrue Crime, Representations of Serial Killers on Screen. You're going to see, by the way, these are really different subjects from each other. Next up, Jake Cooper, Black is in Fashion, Jordan Peele's Cinematic Exploration of Contemporary America. Excuse me then. Yasmin Yuan, Fat is Ugly, The Negative Portrayal of Women's Narrative, Agency and Body Image on Screen. George Onslow, Yearning for a Stranger Time, How Nostalgia is Represented Within Stranger Things. And then Holly Britton, The Romanticization of Alcoholism and Drug Addiction in Fictional Television. A really broad church here of topics. And I think it says a lot that earlier on I had absolutely no idea who was going to win this, but I've opened the envelope, and so I can tell you the winner is Jake. Well done, Jake.
Wow, wasn't really expecting this at all. Like to first off thank my lecturers, Stuart, Adam, Mark, and Terence. You've all been incredible throughout this journey. My amazing friends and classmates, Yasmin in particular, and of course my parents. Without them, I would not be standing here today. So, and my incredible partner as well, can't forget that. I'll be told off. Thank you guys.
So now we have Best Script, presented by Stephen Desmond.
Hi there, how are you? I was taken unawares there, really. So, Best Screenplay. First, I'd like to congratulate all of you on completing your degrees and producing fantastic films, screenplays, and other creative projects. And we wish you a long, hot, and relaxing summer with lots of time for enjoyment and chilling out. And then as you start your careers, remember that we're always here to write you references, come back, and it's always a pleasure to look at your work, read your scripts, help you edit your films. So that's what's in it for us, is to see you go out there and do well in your career. So storytellers are central to filmmaking. This year I so enjoyed being part of our students' creative process in generating feature-length final major project screenplays that have memorable characters, socially relevant themes, and are full of creative imagination. So the nominees are Harvey Holt for Pregnant Pauses, Sam Porter for Worm, Carlos Silva for Below Zero, Stefan Gorgiev for Blasphemous, and Catalina Atasanova for Level 100. Drum roll. And the winner is Harvey Holt for Pregnant Pauses. Congratulations.
I'll get your award.
Oh, yeah. Oh, God. I was caught out on surprise here. I'm on my third drink already, so please be easy on me. Thank you so much to all the lecturers, especially Stuart Joy for the course leader, and of course, Stephen Desmond. Without your advice, your inspiration, your stories, like, I couldn't have done it. I want to thank my friends, my family, my peers for all the support and just advice, and of course the terrible life decisions and circumstances that helped inspire my story. thank you so much. It's been a pleasure being at Solent University.
Who but else but John Hesse for Best Adapted Screenplay.
The Best Adapted Screenplay recognizes the incredible skill and artistry involved in translating the script from the page to the screen. Each nominee in this category has demonstrated an exceptional ability to transform words into images, to preserve the essence of a story while infusing it with the magic of the moving image. And the nominees are Fergus MacLean for Ant Farm, Lara Hannafin for Honey Trap, Zofia Bujaki for Frequency, Emily Stanzel for Murg, and Sean Collins for Glass Hearts. And the winner is Zofia Bujaki.
Hi, thank you so much. I'm so surprised. This is so great. Thank you so much, first of all, to the crew. You're so amazing. It was such a pleasure to work with all of you. And thank you to the cast, and thank you to all the supporters as well. Thank you if you guys bought a ticket for one of our pop quizzes or Indiegogo campaigns. I really appreciate it. I really enjoyed making this film, and thanks to my parents and family and friends. So yeah, thanks so much. Thank you.
And so we are going to begin with Best Documentary, presented by Dr. Roy Honey. Round of applause for Roy, please. Yeah, but don't forget the award. Yeah.
So the nominations are quite interesting because they're all students who joined us just for the last year for the final major project and for their final year, and they're all international students. So I'm really pleased to announce who they are. So we have three nominations. Michael's project takes us on a mesmerizing journey through the vibrant world of jazz. Nice. Beatrice's project delves deep into the captivating history of Ecuadorian surfing. And you'll learn a lot, if you watch the film, you'll learn a lot from it. Tatiana's project unravels a compelling family secret. And the winner is, can we have a drum roll? Tatiana.
So much. I'm so nervous. First of all, I want to thank my grandma because she's the one who inspired me to do this project. To Roy, who guided me in this process, and to my friends Tom, Michael, and Bea. This is for you guys. thank you very much.
Okay, so now we turn our attention to Best Production Design, and this will be read out by Dr. Cameron Quershi.
Good evening, everyone. Some of you may be aware already that I directed Only Love Matters, a film, and I won one of that award, which I'm going to announce today, which is Best Production Design. These individuals are responsible for creating the visual world of your film, from the grandest set to the smallest details. Their work set the tone and immersed the audience in the story. Please join me in congratulating these talented artists for their outstanding work, and the nominees are Annick Edison, for Ant Farm. Rebecca Johnson for Red Wine Stains. Alice Notman for Meg. Kitty Pilcher for Frequency. Senil Ranatunga and Jack O'Donnell. And finally, Theodore Cambo for Les. And the winner is, oh, how can we read this? No, it's my friend. It's my friend, Senil Ranatunga and Jack O'Donnell. Hooray! No, I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. Where's my wand?
Yeah, sure. Hi, much like everyone else here, I was not expecting to win this award.
I don't know why I'm here, to be honest, but...
Yeah, but we're both up here.
Yeah, it was a group effort, to be fair. We spent many a night building the AI and doing all the kind of things, fighting constantly.
Yeah.
But, yeah, well done.
Yeah.
Anybody want to thank?
Everyone, especially our group, especially Paul's sister Sarah for designing the posters. They were fantastic. And just all of our group, friends, family, etc.
All right, nicely done.
Thank you.
Well done. Cool.
Very much.
Okay, so now I'd like to invite Julian Tester up onto the stage, who's going to be presenting two awards for Best Sound Design, followed by Best Editing. Round of applause for Julian.
All right. Sound is often a misunderstood or misrepresented discipline, but it is one of the most important, vital ones. Ones that ground the cinematic world in reality in something rich. And I'm really happy that these films were emblematic of that discipline. The nominees are Francisco Ferreira Barros for What I Know Remains, Elias Highsmith for Frequency, Joseph Miller and Joshua Smith for Reflection. Sindra Rissa Fossey for Eyes Everywhere. Yeah! Oh, and The Black Voice by Renato Volco, which should be there. The winner is Renato for The Black Voice, but I don't think he's here, so you'll get it. I don't know if anyone from his group is here. Yeah, unfortunately. Okay. So best editing. Editing is often a very solitary, meditative, and somewhat patient art, but it's always rewarding. And as an editor myself, I am really relieved and pleased to see that the future of the craft is in such capable hands. Going forward. So the nominees are Che Bars for Merg, Francisco Ferreira Barros for I Am Romance, Henrique Chambel for Honey Trap, Joshua Smith for Reflections, Anna Masana for Ant Farm. And the winner is Che Mark.
Actually, really didn't expect this. I want to thank all of Mer. Just want to point out you spelt Mer wrong, 7H. Thank you for being here. Shannon, I love you. Let's go.
Marco, can you take ownership for that typo? Is that okay? No? Okay. Best Cinematography, up next, presented by Remy Attani.
Since I'm not a cinematographer and I'm a director, I'm going to give a few words about what I think cinematography is. I think to be a great cinematographer is to be a great listener, not only a great technician. To be able to not only implement a beautiful picture, but also implement the vision of the director. And on this note, the best cinematography nominees are I Am What Remains, Solomon Bernard, Honey Trap, Romy Statter, The Black Boys, Alif Hassan, The North Ridge, Frederick Steinbeck, and Ant Farm by Hagen Maddock and George Donovan. And best cinematography winner is Honey Trap, Romy Statter.
Congratulations to all the nominees. Shout out to Honey Trap crew, who slayed. Especially Lara, who's been the director of this, but also my best friend throughout it all. And yeah, shout out to my parents. It's our wedding anniversary today, so love you.
All right, so now we have best producer to be read out by Jonathan Plummer.
I was going to tell a joke about being a producer, but I tested it on a few people and they all said no. So I'm not going to tell that joke. However, I'm just going to tell you a quick thing about being a producer. And if you want to, if being a producer is a thing you want to do, then I urge you to, if you've not already done this, subscribe to Paramount Plus and watch a series called The Offer, which is about the making, the true story, it's a dramatization, the true story of the making the film The Godfather. Now, The Godfather, for all those under 60, which is everybody apart from me, it was a film released in 1975 about the mafia and made by Paramount, but when the producer Al Ruddy, played by Miles Teller, he says, I want to make this film. Nobody wants anything to do with it. The guy who owns Paramount says no. The head of production says no. And he says, he fights for it. He persuades them to make The Godfather. Then he wants to hire Francis Ford Coppola to direct it. And everybody says, no, it's a disaster. And he gets Francis Ford Coppola. Then he wants to hire... The microphone's bored with this story already. He wants to hire Mario Puzo, who wrote the novel, to write the screenplay. And everyone says, no, you don't do that. That's the worst thing you possibly do. It'd be a disaster. He gets that. He fights for it. He gets that. Goes into production. He wants to have Al Pacino. Coppola wants Al Pacino to star in it. Everybody says, no, who's he? Who's Al Pacino? Never heard of him. Disaster. He gets Al Pacino. He gets Marlon Brando to star in it as well. And they go into production in New York, a film about the mafia. And the mafia says, no. So he has to go and negotiate with the mafia and get them on board. And then he has to get the Teamsters involved because nothing moves in New York without the Teamsters Union. And he's just fighting fires all the time, all the way through the production process. And he finally, they make the Godfather is finished, it's released, it's a smash hit at the box office, and it wins Best Picture Oscar. So the point about this story is that, you know, a producer's job, you are carrying around a fire extinguisher the whole time, fighting fires all the time, and negotiating and so on. And then you get to make your project. And he had to really believe in this project, because most people would have said, you know what, this is too much, I'm not going to bother going on with this. But he did, he made The Godfather. And then about 30 years later, he won Best Picture Oscar for Million Dollar Baby, which you may have seen, the Clint Eastwood directed fight film. Anyway, so, you know, that's a word of advice. If you're interested in being a producer, go and watch the series, The Offer, on Paramount Plus. Fantastic series. Anyway, so the best producer, nominations are as follows. Are they going to come up in the order I've got them? I'm going to just go for it. Harrison Armstrong for Ant Farm. Yes, I've got that. Now, this is a bit of a challenge. Coretta Marie Mansaka. Very good. Nicholas Adams for Reflection. Sam Gibson for Untold Lies. Desiree Di Pietro for Honey Trap. And Joey Green for I Am What Remains. And the winner is... I don't even know. Harrison Armstrong for Ant Farm.
I have nothing in planning upon the switch, but thank you so much, guys. I really do appreciate this award. Big love to everyone here, innit? Sweet.
Feel free to indulge in the speeches now, because we're going to be done in like 10 minutes, but that's fine. You know, there's plenty of time at the bar, and you can always go to the pub afterwards. Okay, so up next, we have Best Director, once again presented by Remy Itani.
Okay, there is a lot to say about what it takes to be a director, but if it was to summarize it, is to believe in your vision as like the ultimate truth. Like, that's the only way to go forward. And on this note, I'm going to read the nominees for Best Director. Fergus MacLean, Ant Farm. Lara Hanafin, Honey Trap. Senal Ranatunga, I Am What Remains. Zofia Bujaki, Frequency. Parashant Chapagain, Reflection. And the winner of Best Director is Senal Ranatunga, I Am What Remains.
I'd like to thank my parents, of course, also my mate in Japan, Sean, who's basically helped me out for all my breakdowns. Ooh. I'd also have to shout out to Marco and Prena Winters, who basically witnessed me have my hair fall out with all the stress I had with this film. But thank you so much.
Cheers. I'm impressed with the speech. They're very quickly. They're very quick. Okay, so we're going to move on now to Outstanding Student Achievement. I don't really know what to say about this particular category because it sums up so many of you as to what you've achieved over these past 3 years. So it's really hard to identify what we have here, which is four specific individuals who are nominated for this award. So let's take a look at who they are. First nominated is Ella Perkis. Ella's path throughout the degree has been far from ordinary. She's faced and conquered numerous obstacles, showcasing her spirit and unwavering commitment to the film and television industries. Throughout her time with us, Ella has encountered physical and mental challenges that would have deterred many others. But instead of succumbing to those pressures, she continually chose to rise above them, transforming setbacks into stepping stones on her path to success. From group difficulties to creative challenges, Ella tackled each hurdle with grace, resilience, and a relentless pursuit of excellence. Next up, we have Becky Holmes. Becky's journey throughout the degree program has been nothing short of extraordinary. Despite the demands of her full-time employment as a production assistant on the CBeebies program, the Football Academy, she's also managed to strike a delicate balance, remaining fully committed to her studies and excelling in her academic pursuits at the same time. Next, we have Natasha Hardesty. Natasha represents the spirit of what it means to succeed. For 3 years, she's outperformed and exceeded the requirements of the brief through hard work and focus. When the brief asks for 10 pages, she creates 100. In her final year of study, when tasked to create 2 to 4 minutes of an animated film, she created more than 7 and worked on content for the NTFS on the side. 7 minutes of animation, for those of you who are unfamiliar, is over 10,000 frames of handcrafted artwork. Next and finally, we have Jason Dean. Despite conducting his final year remotely from his home in Blackpool, Jason's produced a genuinely significant portfolio of Houdini work that crosses the genres of motion graphics and simulation with a technical and creative depth that many artists in the industry would be proud of. Jason has a great attention to detail in all aspects of his work and always goes the extra mile on any feedback that he receives on that work. So, the winner. This award, I should note, is sponsored by Neck of the Wood Films, and we are delighted to welcome Craig Dougal here, who represents the company. So the winner of the Outstanding Achievement Student Achievement Award and £250 cash prize courtesy of Neck of the Wood Films, a one-to-one mentorship and a bespoke package of film literature is Ella Perkis.
Sorry, I was just saying my hands are a bit sweaty there, but firstly, obviously, thank you to Stuart because he's just been absolutely amazing. He's been so, so good through my whole experience with all these hard things he was talking about. And then obviously the obligatory, you know, friends and family and other lecturers, but specifically my mum who's watching from work. So, yeah. Ta-da!
Okay, we come to our final two awards of the evening, and the first of which is the Audience Award, and this will be delivered by your wonderful film production course leader, Marco Granesi. Marco's going to follow this up also with the Best Film Award afterwards.
Hello, everyone. It's lovely to see you. I just want to say a few words very quickly to all of you, or specifically the film production students, year three. Hello. Honestly, it's been a great pleasure to be your lecturer, to teach you to make films with you, or helping out making films, I suppose. And it's been great to see how much you've progressed in these 3 years. Thank you. Can I get the envelope as well? Come on. Thank you, Stuart, by the way, for organizing this. Now we're close to Stuart. So yeah, where was I? It's been great to see how you've progressed as filmmakers and as individuals as well. The testament to this progress is basically your FMPs, all the films that you've created in these last 9 months or so. And I'm sure I'm speaking for all the lecturers on the teaching team, not just the FMP teaching team, but all the lecturers on the degree. Your FMPs have been, they've really inspired us. They have inspired us because you have found a way to get your voices out, to find that voice and raise it as well at points when it was necessary. And you've done that to try and tackle or explore some very interesting themes, such as being a parent. That stuff is really close to me. Or dealing with technology, or choosing your friends, choosing them right, and once again, as you do all the time, falling and realizing that you can do a better job on that as well. Your films have been about the depths of loneliness, the intricacies of love, and the difficult dynamics of family relationships. And your films have also reminded us that it's very important, as it is hard, to deal with our memories and our past. And that, one way or another, we all have to leave a mark in our worlds and with the people that are close to us. So yes, your work has touched us. As I said, this is from myself, but the whole teaching team. It has provoked thoughts, and it has reminded us once again of the power of cinema to inspire and challenge. Your talent and creativity has left an indelible mark on our film community already. And with that, I mean you guys, us in this room, and all the other film students in the department. As you continue with your journey, please continue developing that voice. And again, if necessary, raise it. And continue telling stories that matter to you, because those will be the stories that will matter to an audience as well, like you did this time round. Your dedication has been exceptional, and you've really demonstrated to have immense talent that you can only continue developing. And we can't wait to see your next film. So, stay in touch and make sure that you send us a link once you're out of this place, once you get in the real world. Thank you. That's the thing, you see, there's no envelope because there are no nominees for this. Because the award that I'm presenting is the Audience Award, which recognizes the film that has resonated deeply with the audience. You guys have watched the films, also people external to the university. And it's captured our art, with captivating imagination. It is a testament to the filmmaker's ability to connect with people, to evoke emotions, and leave a lasting impression. Now, the winner of the Film and Media Audience Award is I Am What Remains by Sanaa Ranatunga.
I would like to thank all the people, crew members who weren't here to be here. Victor Cuyelli, my AD, honestly did everything perfectly. He was amazing. He didn't know how to do his job, and then on the day he just smashed it out.
He learns quickly, and I wish he was here. Another person is Kit Rivington-Mayer. He was a composer for this film. He did a lot of sound design. He isn't here today either, and he's done another amazing job. Our first AC, Jay Young, he did an amazing
Let's
job.
Let's go!
Jay had to deal with the perfect lighting of f-stop, like what, 2.8, 1 point something, I don't know, my whatever. But he had to deal with that bullshit lighting that,
Don't swear.
Bleep that out. But yeah, he had to deal with that mess of lighting, and I don't think this film would be as any good if it wasn't for that. Thank you so much.
Okay, it's me again. Last but not least, best film. So we've got one for each member of the team. Cool. Okay, so the best film showcases a seamless fusion of artistic talent and craftsmanship, where each department has played a crucial role in bringing the director's vision to life. From the cinematographer's engaging visuals to the editor's meticulous pacing, from the sound designer's immersive audio to the production designer's compelling set, as well, obviously, as the producer's meticulous orchestration of all the logistics. Every department has to work tirelessly to create a cohesive and impactful cinematic experience under the guidance of the film director. The award celebrates the power of collaboration and the ability of a team to elevate a film beyond individual contributions. It recognizes the combined efforts, dedication, and expertise of all those involved in the process. Now, the nominees are six. And it wasn't an easy decision to make this one. But let's move on to the nominees. The first one is Ant Farm by Fergus MacLean. And the second one is Honey Trap, Lara Anafin. Sorry about the misspell. Merg, Emily Stanzel. I Am What Remains, Sanal Ranatunga. Reflection, Prashant Chape. Frequency, Sophia Bujaki. And the Best Film Award goes to... Frequency, Jafia Bujaki.
Happy that I saw all of your films, because I'm so happy that after all these COVID years we were able to make films, and all of your films were so beautiful and I was so touched by it. So like, let's break this, or I don't know, so everyone can get it. I don't want to talk too much
I just want to say thank you so much to our lecturers and Solent for helping us and supporting us to create this film. It was not an easy one. As you can see, there was one frame in the film where there were three kids and three animals. And I think that was the first thing that you guys taught me, not to work with kids or animals. So we did just that. So sorry about that. I'll let the crew speak because they did the work, so thank you.
Okay, I would like to say thanks to everyone, everyone from the crew for great collaboration and everyone outside of the main crew who helped us. There were so many people helping us daily, carrying the project forward. So massive thank you guys for carrying with me as a big bad producer. And I want to say in Slovak, thanks to my parents for supporting me, if you don't mind. Ďakujem, ďakujem mama, ďakujem otci, že ste mi pomohli. Ďakujem.
Mom, I know you're watching on the live stream, so I love you.
Hi, thank you so much for this. Frequency was a really amazing experience and definitely really, really challenging. But from someone who did their department by themselves, the crew were absolutely fantastic in helping me work to do the best sound. Thank you so much to our composer, Will McCarthy from Ireland. And he was absolutely incredible, made the most amazing music. Thank you to my parents, my mum, my dad, and my brother, and all of my family at home. And thank you all to you as film production students for making me, as a young trans person looking to get into the industry, feel so welcome. And I know this country is really pursuing people like me at the moment, and hoping this generation will be different. You gave me that hope. Thank you so much.
I was doing DOP and I was always feeling I'm not perfect in the group, but I think we were like no one was perfect, that's why we could support each other. And I really thanks to everyone, our crew, and especially my camera department, camera operator Josh, Gaffer, Tom, and Vicky, first AC, I think she's over there. Yeah, and everyone, also my parents, I'm sure they are proud of me. I think Japan is 8 hours difference, so I think they're sleeping right now, but yeah, I'm gonna text them later. Thank you so much.
Also, thank you to Marius, who was supposed to be our editor, but life got in the way. We just want to say thanks to him as well. And Vicky, who's somewhere behind us. Nagyon köszi, Vicky. Nagyon szeretünk. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Okay, so that brings the first annual Film and Media Awards to a close. You've been amazing. You are amazing. Thank you so much. Only one swear word, and it's okay. We'll let it slide. The live stream was broken anyway, so we are going to make a recording that's going to be available, and we'll send it out via email, so you can send that recording to your friends and family, so you've got a memory of the night. Listen, you have always impressed me, inspired me, so continue to do that. I look forward to watching your journeys move forward. Have a great rest of the night. The bar closes at 8:45, so get your last orders in, and then maybe head to the pub afterwards.
Giddy bridge, that's all I'm saying.
Thanks once again.